I want you to respond to this new ad that was came out yesterday, apparently $1 million buy by some Republican group out there that basically charges that your foreign policy is very close to President Obama's foreign policy, and they specifically have a quote from you back in 2007. I'll play a little clip of it.
The Senate is considering tough new sanctions on Iran. President Obama says he'll veto them, and Rand Paul is standing with him. Rand Paul supports Obama's negotiations with Iran, and he doesn't understand the threat.
You know, it's ridiculous to think that they're a threat to our national security.
Rand Paul is wrong and dangerous. Tell him to stop siding with Obama, because even one Iranian bomb would be a disaster.
All right, well, I want you to respond to that, but specifically the 2007 quote where you said that Iran was not a real threat to the United States.
Well, you know, I think the whole thing's sort of a farce and factually incorrect. In fact, PolitiFact said it was mostly false. When you look at the actual facts on the ground, I've been one of the leading proponents saying that any agreement that we come to with Iran has to come back and be voted on by Congress. I've been saying repeatedly that I'm skeptical for the main reason that Iran's foreign minister is now tweeting out in English that the agreement doesn't mean what President Obama says the agreement means. And so really, I think that people are desperate somehow to latch on to the status quo. And so they put out falsehood, but there's really nothing about the ad that's correct. Even the statement from 2007, even in 2007, I did believe that Iran was potentially a threat and developing a nuclear weapon was bad. And now 8 years later, which is a long time, I think the threat has become heightened. So I think it's unfair to take statements out of context from 8 years ago and then to basically lie about my position on Iran now.
Because in 2007, you did say, we heard you say it, it's ridiculous to think that they're a threat to our national security. But what I hear you saying is your views have changed.
But that's not to say that in 2007, them developing a nuclear weapon wouldn't be a threat. Really, the threat to the United States that we've always been concerned with is developing intercontinental ballistic missiles and developing a nuclear weapon. So that statement taken out of context, even in 2007, isn't to say that I didn't believe developing a nuclear weapon was a good thing or that that might not be a threat. But I think after 8 years, one thing we do all know is that events change. And as you've seen, their capacity and their ability to quickly build a nuclear weapon has become more significant and more immediate over time. But I think the main thing about this is these are people, this is sort of this neocon community, and the neoconservatives have really never met a war they didn't like. And so what you'll see is that these attacks saying, oh, you're close to Obama's position, in reality, the neocons who have been with President Obama on the war in Libya, they've been with President Obama on wanting to bomb Assad, and they were really also for taking out Hussein. Everything that they've been for over the last decade has really been to make America less safe and to make the region more chaotic. So I think we could have a good intellectual debate about this, but attack ads like this that are mostly untrue, if not entirely false, probably don't serve the public very well.
You want to name names when you're criticizing or blasting these so-called neocons?
Well, you know, if these people would release their donors, then we'd know who they are. But these are people who want to be in the shadows and have something secret and then put up a bunch of lies. But I think there are people that you'll see in the Senate who basically favored giving arms to Gaddafi, and then the next year they were favoring giving arms to the so-called freedom fighters. But now it turns out that the war they had in Libya, which supported by the neocons and President Obama, the war's a disaster. Radical jihad has run amok in Libya. It's chaotic. And I think we're more likely to be attacked by people organizing in Libya than we were before the war. So people need to think through when war is in our interest and when war is not in our interest.
I want to give you also a chance to clarify your position on foreign aid, specifically foreign aid to Israel. Israel, as you know, gets about $3 billion a year in economic and military assistance from the United States. Back in 2011, you and I had a pretty famous exchange. I'll play that clip.
I don't think funding both sides of an arm race, particularly when we've got to borrow the money from China to send it to someone else, we just can't do it anymore. The debt is all-consuming, and it threatens our well-being as a country.
All right, so just to be precise, and all foreign aid, including the foreign aid to Israel as well, is that right?
Yes.
All right, but you don't believe that anymore, do you?
Well, the interesting thing is, yes, I still believe it, and people keep reporting that I've changed my opinion, but here are the facts. I said in my speech today, I said in my announcement speech, we can't borrow money from China to give it to Pakistan. But I have acknowledged over the last 4 years that I'm in the minority, and so what I've been trying to do is say, look, to begin with, why don't we eliminate foreign aid from those who hate us and burn our flag? And that would be enemies of ours and enemies of Israel. But my position on foreign aid really is no different than Netanyahu's position. In 1996, he came here to a joint session of Congress, and he said that ultimately he believes that Israel will be stronger by being independent of foreign aid. But people try to misreport this, and I know you know how emotional this issue is with Israel. People try to misreport this as that I am somehow targeting Israel to remove aid to Israel and that I'm not a friend or an ally of Israel, and nothing could be further from the truth. I've supported the Iron Dome. I've supported our alliance with Israel. I'm one of the people probably most prominent in Congress to say that it's wrong of American officials to be criticizing Israeli policy on where they build or what they decide on their internal politics. So I think that as long as it's reported accurately, my position really hasn't changed. Ultimately, I believe, as Netanyahu does, that Israel will be stronger when they're entirely free of foreign aid.
All right, let's move.